How to use Coinglass liquidation heatmap, full tutorial and my personal experience after 1 year of using it. Step number one, you need to open this liquidation heatmap, and what you do, you go to their website, liquidation heatmap. I will add link into description if you don't know how to find it. After that, here you have this page if you use my link. In the case if you didn't do it, here you will have in the higher bar liquidations. Here would be liquidation heatmap and heatmap model 2. Choose any of this one, for example heatmap, and you would have this map. In the case if you open any other page, still you can scroll down here and you can see liquidation heatmap, liquidation heatmap model 2. Congrats, at this moment you open heatmap. What menu do we have at this moment? Let's analyze it together. Support me with your like, I would be really thankful. The next step in the heatmap would be to choose a model. What's the difference between these two models? How they represent the data. I prepared for you two screenshots with same time and coin to see what's the difference between models. Here it's example for you how model 2 looks, and here example for you how model 1 looks. I think model 1 shows to you more exact level where biggest liquidation would occur, for example like this one. It shows you more levels, exactly levels like this one or here, for example level, or here level, or this level at all-time high. But this one, as you can see, it shows to you more area where people shows to you biggest liquidations. I personally use this one because I like to analyze key zones where most of the people would be liquidated. You can try both of them and see which one better for you. When you chose model, after that you will need to choose a pair or a symbol here. Pair or a symbol. What's the difference? Pair, it is exactly pair on exchange. Example, Bitcoin USDT futures on Binance. It is exact pair on exact exchange. But you also can have BTC USDT on Bybit or OKX or other exchanges. That's why if you use a pair, better to use Binance because it is still biggest crypto exchange on the planet that gives you biggest data. In the case if you like me, you use a symbol. Symbol gives you aggregated data. They add data about many exchanges together and shows to you like one chart. I like aggregated. The next one, when you chose a symbol, here you can choose a pair. You can choose a coin. Bitcoin, Ethereum, you can search at this moment. You can here write any coins that you wish. For example, Toncoin, Telegram, Open Network, Toncoin. When you choose a coin, let's go back to Bitcoin. Here you will need to use a time frame, time period. 24 hours, it is obviously, it shows to you 24 hours what happened with a coin. Let me show to you each of them. 3 days, it shows you last 3 days. And right now you can see major liquidity during this 1 week. Here you can see that at this high, like biggest liquidation at 72. 1 month. 3 months at this moment. And of course 6 months and yearly. In what cases, what time period you need to use? First, as bigger period, that means bigger trades you need to take. If you open, for example, 6 months or a year, it is only for people that take trades and keep them for example, for months, to build the position, etc. For these cases, you use 6 months a year. In a case, if you do swing trades, better to use 3 months because you can see major areas where biggest liquidity is accumulated. Like you can see biggest liquidity at this high or biggest liquidity where here when price took it or here or here, or when price took this low, this one here, biggest liquidity value. In the case if you are a scalper and you trade intraday only, in that case I recommend you to use 1 month and 1 week because it can shows to you exactly some local levels where biggest liquidity is accumulated. How do I use it personally? Before I tell you, I invite you to join our community where we educate people and give them signals where we exactly take trades with stop losses and take profits. And at this moment you can see example results of our students and clients that make money with us. Join right now, link will be in description. I personally like to use this stuff only in a range market. In a range market, for me, it is just awesome because example, like even this Ethereum liquidity, they took this high of a range. In that cases, it's just amazing. Or this example on Ethereum, you can see a price took low of a range. After that price took high of a range. Here they took high of a range, low of a range. During range market, just the best. But when price start and trend market, you might see something like this. Price moves, biggest liquidation is at low, but price don't take it. That's why, my friend, I highly recommend you to use it with a cold mind. For me, way better to use it with other patterns as with order flow, volume profile, open interest, and that's the reason why at this moment I recorded for you and share with you my lessons where I prepared for you free trading strategies that I use it for bull, bear and a range market, and with this liquidation heat maps in only make it way better. Watch and make money.